Greetings, amazing people. I had to move my chair. Now my wire for my headphones are all tangled up in me and this is amazingly crazy. I am going to talk about UK UI. It's a desktop environment made for a Ubuntu-based distribution, I think for the Chinese market, with their own UI and whatnot. And if we go in here and we look a little bit at it here, the UK UI, it's I'm here, you can download. I don't know what this is going to take me to, but I kind of want to see a little bit of what's going on here. It's Qt based. This is the first time I'm running it, and I am running it on the Arch, so it may not be the right representation of the desktop, but I will try and go into it a little bit and talk about it and give my crazy opinions on it, of course. And again, I think it stems from, of course, China, and it's meant to be a desktop for the Chinese version of Ubuntu, if I'm not mistaken. I could be totally wrong here, and I probably am. They say it a little bit here that UK use technology is mainly developed using Qt, and it's integrating on the Unicorn system by default. But they are talking a little bit about the project here. We can go on to GitHub and see how active it is. So how do I, can I not just go to it, copy it, paste it, there you go. Oh, yesterday there's quite a lot going on here, and here they talk about how we can add the PPA to get it for your Ubuntu derivative devices. Technologies, DBus, X11, GLib, Qt, GTK, DevDconf, and stuff like that. News. Let's see what they have here. They seem to be quite up to date with the news. They seem to be quite into it. Again, I haven't really read up much about this, to be honest, because it seemed like that Chinese distribution or Chinese-based projects don't give much, I would not say love, but attention by YouTubers. And I get that a little bit. I think it's the, how can I say this without going into politics, but I feel that to some extent we have to separate the people from the government. Let's try and put it that way. So just because it's from China or around that area, don't mean, I hope that's the case anyway, that the government is not going in and messing around with it and acting crazy with them. And yeah, Ubuntu Kylin is the distribution it's made for. So I hope they are their own independent thing, that they are working for themselves, by themselves, and they don't have any pesky big brother looking over them. So let's look at this as we would look at any other project, you know, like if it was, no matter where it's made, let's just don't think about where it's made, but what they are giving us. You know, what kind of product are they giving us? So let's look at that. And like I said here, they have quite a active development. Well, you can say that about the things from China. The things happen. You know, they don't sleep and rest on their laurels a lot of times. They tend to keep working at it. And we have a smart little preview. This down here reminds me a little bit of Dash to Pan or Dash to Dog. And this must be the, what is it called? You know, day and night cycle, where night mode. There you go. And let's look at the calendar. That's quite good. What happens if I right click, or do I can't do that? What if I right click down here? Time and date setting. There you go. Again, the theming may be off a little bit. I just installed it on the Arch, and this is my first look at it. Date area. And why am I looking at this? Well, we have Qt Fizz coming out, and CyberOS with all their Qt based desktop environments, and I known about this here for a while, you know, this environment here for a while, and I kind of feel and think a little bit that these guys here are doing it the best, and it, all the rest, again, when I say that, it's from what I have read and what I have seen of pictures and stuff like that on the internet. And I feel like Cute Fish and all the others is basically just trying to copy the UK UI desktop environment or Ubuntu Kylin environment to some extent. What is this we have down here? Oh, so this is kind of like, the Raven menu for Botchy plugins clock. Oh, we have a stopwatch, we have a count. Exit program, sure. Like, so far, the English is quite good. Welcome to use Kylin. It's better than most. Close the desktop node page at the same... Oh, they are missing something here. Yes. We have audio. What happens if I... Oh, so we can go in here. Input device. Application audio. I kind of like this. We are going over this meticulously and a little bit cumbersome, because again, I've seen pictures of it. I've heard people talk about it a little bit in articles. I haven't run it myself, other than I think I installed it once and then was like, I didn't even boot it up, so to speak. I just installed it and forgot about it, and then I nuked my system. At that time, it was an Arch system. So this is their file manager. All tags. Oh, we can have tags. And I have to say one thing. I think this is a themed out dolphin. Oh, no, it's not. It could be a fork of dolphin. I don't know. It looks a lot like dolphin, though. The thing, what I was trying to say is that from all the desktop and all, like, if you look at the... thing, you know, desktop environments and this Linux distribution like Debian and stuff like that. I will say this, I may not like the theme. Again, I haven't themed this. This is just how Arch has it by default. It may be themed differently on Ubuntu Kylin. But from a usability standpoint, I do like what they are doing. I really like what Debian is doing. And what I'm seeing so far here is that I don't hate to say this, but it seems like they have a better understanding of UI and UIX design than most other developers have, and they take a little bit more pride in that. Not only does it look nice, but it's actually functioning nice, you know, like it makes sense, you know, they have these things at the right places. They're not trying to make you do things and follow paradigms that makes no sense. You know, they are following a traditional paradigm here with desktop icons and stuff like that. And we'll go into the theme managers later. And I just feel like they are more in tune with how people actually use their computer compared to, like, that say, the GNOME developers and the Pantheon developers and you know, those kind of desktop environments that take away desktop icons and remove maximize button and minimize buttons and stuff like that. The guys over in China land, or what you would call it, they seem to be a little bit more in tune with how people actually use their computer. And it's something I noticed with all these softwares coming out from that area, is that I may be skeptical about it. I may be skeptical about, you know, the receive it's coming from and stuff like that. But from a usability standpoint, it's not bad. Oh, so this is like their multitasking here. If you have workspaces. Oh, cool. What is the menu like? I think this is as far as I got when I installed it like a month ago. I installed it and I opened the menu here. And I have also XFCE installed, so you will see some XFCE things in here. I do like this menu a little bit. I don't know if I like it. What's this? Okay, so here's it's put up into categories. Right, my microphone is actually in the way. I need to do a better positioning of the microphone. I actually like that you can do this. It reminds me a little bit. This here reminds me a little bit of the... what is the menu that the Botchy is using? I can't remember it right now. What happens if I click here? Okay, this... Oh, we have a moped outside or something like that. This I don't like that much. I've never been a fan of these full-blown, full-screen menu-driven things here. Maybe it's just because I'm of the a little bit older generation with these kind of paradigms here. But I like that you can actually switch between this. And let's say if I do till the search results are quite good. What do we have down here? That must be the user. Again, we will look at the settings manager in a bit ski. This must be... that's to the computer or the file manager. Ooh, cool. So this setting, this must be shut down. And I probably am missing quite a lot, but I think the most interesting for us nerdy configuration guys must be the Ubuntu Kylin Control Center, I think, what the UK CC stands for here. This is something, like a control center is a need nowadays, if you ask me, because that's what people are used to from Windows world. So message, notice about. So I think this is the notification center here. So notice settings, battery. We don't have any battery in here, so we can just take that out. About. It has not seen our kernel, CPU, memory, or disk. I am in a virtual box, of course. And I think these up here is the shortcuts. If I click down here, we'll go home. Date time, date area. So here's the English is going to be a little bit crazy. It could also be, I haven't installed the right fonts and stuff like that. Current area, US, or format area. Okay, so that's how it's format calendars and stuff like that. You can then add other languages. Date here, sync network time, change time zone, 24 hour clock. It takes a little bit of time before that refreshes, but that's good. Network, so connection, VPN proxy. Not bad, to be honest. It's simplistic, but it's not bad. Then we have devices, a printer, mouse, keyboard. We can add printer scanners, mouse, hand habits. Maybe that should be worked a word a little bit different. The mouse speed. Oh, here we have some double click delay. Oh, okay. So I thought this was like a toggle, but it's a cat. Pointer setting, speed, acceleration. Yeah, I definitely don't want to have that. Visibility. I don't know what that is. Cursor settings, enable flashing at text area. Touchpad, no touchpad found. Keyboard. Well, you get your most normal, settings, I guess you would call it. Shortcuts, audio, this is the one I want. Built-in audio card. So it's really, I have more than one audio card. So I really value that there's a place to easily change audio cards and devices, because Linux is really bad with audio devices if you have more than one. Update backups, what's this? Check for updates, let's try this one here. I don't know if this works. I am under Arts, by the way. Backup your files or the other device. Restore, begin backup. Yeah, I think we need a program to do these things here that's not with it, because I'm under Arts. Account. See here, the font is a little bit iffy-diffy. It's a little bit iffy-diffy, Bob. Personalization. This is where we go in and have some fun. So let's start with background. Select from pictures. Okay, color. Okay. Browse online wallpaper. Browse local wallpaper. It don't seem to have any function to cycle the wallpaper within like 5 minutes and 10 minutes and stuff like that. And that kind of makes me a little bit sad, because that's a feature I really, really like. And here we are going into... Oh, we can actually click English up here. Reduce the complexity, take the easy way, gentle and intelligent. Okay, so that was just a shortcut to their site then. Browse local wallpaper. So here you can add your folders. This don't look pretty. This looks really bad. Again, it could be my theming. Reset to default. So here we have theming. So after default, we have the dark one. We have default icons. We have classic. And then we have mouse pointers. That's because some of them here I have installed myself. Effects, transparency. So I did change it to dark. Oh, there you go. Default. Dark is... Okay, this may not be right. Default. Dark. So it's opposite. Anyway, screen lock. Show pictures of screen lock on screen login. Yeah, why not? Lock screen when screensaver boost. Yeah, select screen background. Fonts. And I think this is where it starts to be a little bit crazy. Do we have the Ubuntu fonts? We don't have the Ubuntu fonts. I always use the Ubuntu fonts. They look quite cool if you ask me. The screensaver. May there be enough clouds in your life to make a beautiful sunset. Oh, that's kind of nice. I kind of like this. I like if I have to have a screensaver. I hate screensavers, but if I have to have one that gets activated. I like these things here where it like skips you a little bit. So we can have a slideshow. We can have a pop art sequence. We can have floating XFCE. We can have blank only. And we can have the default. Desktop, computer menu, so we can take this on and off, I guess. Again, it don't seem to be working that well. It could be because I'm on the arts. File system menu, trash menu. I have no idea what that means. Panel size, small. Okay, this is small. Panel position, let's try and do top. Yeah, it's not... It's not... working that well. Again, could be because I'm on the arts. System. Display, default apps, power, and auto boot. I do like what I'm seeing here, to be honest. Do I need to reclose or reopen that before it takes... Yeah, so this is still... This is still light. So if I do this... Yeah, now it's working. There you go. I would say Deepin is a little bit more aesthetically pleasing to look at, but now we're talking personal preferences here, of course, and you may like it. So, you know, some like blondes, some like brunettes, some like redheads if they really want to live dangerous, and being afraid of being stabbed in the back while they're sleeping, and some like silver foxes. You get what I'm saying here. It's a personal preference. But I do think this have a lot of potential. It actually have a lot of potential. I kind of see this a little bit, if I'm being honest here, as a mix between XFCE and KDE, or a slimmed down version of KDE, or a better version of LXQT, if that makes any sense whatsoever to you guys. Let's close all this down here. Because I kind of get the LXQT feeling and the XFCE feeling, but also mixed in some KDE feeling and, of course, some Bungie feeling with this over here. So, I would say that it's for people that kind of like a little bit what Qt have to offer, you know, the sleekness, the things like that, and want a kind of a little bit more XFCE experience. I don't like how transparent this is, though. Processes, resources. We can't see what the fuck it says here. It's using 1 gig of memory. Oh well, we also have stuff open. We have Firefox open. It's using. Can I? It's really hard to see. 1 gig of memory. The CPU is quite high, but I think that's because it's rendering these transparencies and stuff like that. What if I go into settings here? In here, and theme, where is it? Transparency. Yeah, that's not good. What if we go up to the default theme? And then we go in here and we do system monitor. Yeah, the theming is a little bit off. Again, I suspect that's because I'm under arts. It's a little bit better to see here. But it's quite a high memory use, to be honest. But this is not uncommon for modern Linux memory use. This is quite high, and I suspect it's because I'm running it in a virtual machine, and it has to deal with all this transparency. And you can see when I move it around, it just go crazy. But it's an interesting project, and I think I will, like, not the Ubuntu Kylin distribution, but this desktop environment, I think I will keep an eye on, because it has a lot of great things. Like I said, it's like if you take Debian and water it down, or you take KDE and watering it down, or make Debian or KDE into a little bit more a la LXQT, XFCE. That's kind of that vibe that I'm getting from this here, and I really, really do dig and like that. Let's try and do this here. Up. Now it's working. So here, show system monitor. This is a typical Windows thing. Setup panel. Now we're going in here. I'm actually inclined, or I am thinking about actually downloading Ubuntu Kylin here. It says it right here. And actually try and run this native as it is intended under, you know, Ubuntu. So I think I may do that at one point. But anyway, this is just me waffling around with UK UI under Arch, having a little bit of a fun look at it. I do wish I could make this smaller. But I kind of like what I'm seeing here. Again, it a lot of the UI design makes sense. And you make it feels like they have thought about them. What, you know, that the layout of things, and they just not put something together and then be like, oh, it works for me, so it has to work for you. And all, you know, they actually think like they put care into UI design and UIX design, so user design and user experience. Because I feel on that area, I actually feel a high quality of that. Where on other distributions, I feel like, oh, we had a good idea while we were taking a dump, but let's implement it. And if people don't like it, well, they're not as smart as I am, or we are, so therefore they can fuck themselves. That's kind of the feeling I'm getting from a lot of the big distribution and desktop makers right now at the moment, that they got drunk one night, got an idea, and be like, let's implement that because we like it, or we think it could be the future. And everyone is yelling and screaming that they should not do it, but hey, we know better. Anyway, check this out. You can download from it's in the default repositories from Arch. Or download Ubuntu Kylin and take a look which added there, which will probably be the best thing to do. I just happen to have Arch up and running, so that's why I did it in here. See you all later, and bye-bye.